The Chris Evans Breakfast Show with Sky.
It's the delightful David Walliam.
Good morning. Good morning.
Never been called delightful, but thank
well,
you.
What a surprise. So, David, now I have asked you to do many things on the air. I've hijacked you on the air, but then you have done them all for
yes,
us. And don't tell me you didn't have a great time doing them.
I did have a great time. I was interviewed by some chefs.
Yes,
do you remember that?
I do.
I didn't know who most of them were.
Yes.
But the man from Bake Off was there. Do you remember?
Paul Hollywood was there.
Yeah.
That was at my pub.
Yes.
And that night raised over £1 million. So thank you. And
my absolute pleasure. I only took 50% of that as a fee.
Where would you like to go? We could sort this out before 10 o'clock.
I'd like to go places in the UK.
Have you booked anywhere yet this year?
Yeah, I'm going to go to Cornwall.
You could, sometimes you go and stay with Elton, though, don't you, in France?
Yes, I do, but I wasn't going to mention that. I sort of wanted to sound relatable. But you've sort of blown that.
What's the most sportiest thing you've ever done?
Swam the channel.
That's amazing.
That's quite
picked up an award for sports personality.
By the way, that's the best answer to any question I've ever asked you.
I like doing it, but I'm not that into watching it.
David took over this show when we were broadcasting live from the Hay Literary Festival so I could attend Eli's birth.
I didn't get paid a penny.
No.
Let me say that.
But you did agree to be his godfather, and not once has he received a birthday card from you.
Really?
Hang on. When was that?
You agreed to be his godfather.
Did I win?
On the show.
On the show, of course.
Well, I don't remember that.
Everything's on the show, you know. David's new book, The World's Worst Teachers, features a teacher who can't stop farting, or can he? We don't know. And he punishes teachers by sitting them in his farting chair, his chair of farts. Is he a petomane of choice? Does he have?
Yeah, he revels in his own awfulness.
No, but is he? Can he? Is it flatulence that's been brought on by maturing years, or does he choose?
He likes to do it.
He likes to do it.
All right. Who would be most starstruck?
ELO.
Yeah, okay.
ELO, Paul McCartney.
Yeah, Paul McCartney kind of trumps everybody, doesn't he, really?
More or less, I think so. And, you know, he played the pub that you did your talk at.
No, he didn't invite me that year. The year of Paul McCartney.
Well, we didn't need you that year.
I met Paul Hollywood.
We had Paul McCartney. We didn't
need
you.
Yeah, well, I'd rather have seen Paul McCartney.
I know,
than Paul
but it's
Hollywood.
Not about what you want. It's about what the lovely people giving all their money to children's charities want. Unless, of course, you'd like to make a donation, in which case you can come to any gig. It's up to you, David. I would love to. When you're around books, David, do you have a library at home?
Yes, I do. Well, I've got books all over the house.
Okay. But do you have a specific room full of your books on shelves?
What, you mean my own books?
No, just like, do you have a room that's particularly full of books?
Well, my bedroom's full of books, yeah.
All right. And don't you feel solace and calm just being around all those words? I do.
Yeah, I love it.
Just the fact that I know that all those words are in the room, that makes me feel better about everything, or safer.
Yeah. I don't know what it is. It's almost like sort of seeing inside your brain. I once had a date with a girl.
Daily Star will be all over that. Williams has date with girl.
And she kind of comes as a surprise to people. And she saw all these books on my shelf. She went, "You've got a lot of books. What are they all about?"
Oh, no.
I thought, well, you know, about different things, aren't they? Some are biographies, some are autobiographies, some are fiction books.
Special books.
Well, I've got...
You got like a first edition or something like
I've that? I've got a couple of first editions, yeah. Roald Dahl is my absolute hero, yeah. So I've got some signed first editions of his books.
So if there was a fire, let's hope there never is, if there's a fire, would it be the Roald Dahl books that you collect up and you rush out with?
They're probably my son. That would be the priority.
Obviously, Mr. Funny Guy.
Well, I don't
books
know. Yeah, I mean, maybe.
Do you know what? Forget the question.
you know what I take?
What?
I got a little... My granny, who I love very much, she had a little bell. There's a little gold bell, a little sort of boy peeing, a tiny bell. And she used to ring it when it was tea time.
Oh.
And when she died, she gave me the bell because she knew I loved the bell. And it was all I ever wanted because it's just a lovely memory of her and memory of my childhood of her ringing this little bell to tell me it was tea time.
David Walliams, is there any chance of getting David Walliams to wish the Walliams class at the Whitstable and Sea Saltwater Endowed School a very happy summer holidays from Francesca Monk? You have a class named after you.
Isn't that amazing? The Hello Walliams class.
Did
yes,
you know
of course.
That?
Well, there's a few.
Really?
Around the country.
Good
well, I see it on Twitter.
That's good.
Because sometimes they name classes over like authors they like and things like that. So
that is cool.
Hello, Walliams class.
That is cool.
Have a super, super summer holiday.
What a wonderful thing. That must be very fill you with pride, mustn't it?
Yeah, it's amazing.
Well done. Now, you work with Anton Deck on Britain's Got Talent. You've already mentioned it yesterday. Where are we with the next one of that? Because it's quite special, the next series, isn't it?
Well, we're doing a series called BGT Champions.
I know.
We'll actually start filming it next week.
I know.
Okay. Well, why ask me then?
No, because I want you to tell us more about
it. Well, basically, it's past winners and people who've done really well on the British show competing against talent from around the world.
For example, who?
Susan Boyle's in there. Jack Carroll, the brilliant comedian. Do you remember him?
He was a child comedian.
I imagine there's lots of surprises. I mean, actually, I don't know too much who's on because I like to just be surprised and be in the moment and be spontaneous. Because otherwise you start thinking, oh, well, have I got something funny to say about this person or that person? You stop listening to what's going on.
And where will you go after this? Will you go back to a normal Britain's Got Talent or will you continue?
Yeah, this is just like a one-off thing that we're doing. I think it's going to be on in the autumn because it's replacing some of the X Factor. And then we'll do another series, I
presume. Is it just the right laugh to work on?
The challenge of it is waiting for Simon Cowell to arrive. That's the drag. Because
really?
He likes to be about 4 or 5 hours late.
Okay.
And I'm sort of someone who's punctual and on time, so I'm sort of ready to go. And then when he arrives, he's in no rush to start. And the audience are then sort of in a bad mood because they've been waiting for like 8 hours for it to start. And then he gets in front of the audience. He says, I'm sorry we're starting late. The reason is David was eating a 3-course meal. And he said, I'm sorry, the people of Manchester can wait. And we start the show with 3,000 people booing me.
Boo!
He likes to do that every single time. The Chris Evans Breakfast Show with Sky.